Greetings. Is Muhammad the Comforter? This is a summary video. Let's review. How do we know about the Comforter? Jesus told us about the Comforter in John 14:15-17, in John 14:26, John 15:26, and John 16:7-15. We learned from John 14:15-17, He may abide with you forever. That means live with you. The world cannot receive Him because the world cannot see Him. The world doesn't know Him. You already know Him, disciples, for He dwells with you and shall be in you. We learned from John 14:26, He is the Holy Spirit. He is sent in Jesus' name. He will teach you all things, and He will remind you what Jesus said. We learned from John 15:26, whom I, Jesus, will send to you. So the Comforter was sent by Jesus. The Comforter is the Spirit of truth, and He will testify of Jesus, meaning He will confirm and witness regarding Jesus. Confirm, testify, repeat what Jesus said. In all these verses, Jesus was speaking to the disciples. So Jesus is promising the Comforter to the disciples. Yes, there is an implied promise by Jesus to all believers who will follow in the footsteps of the disciples. That means the believers in 100 AD, 200, 300, 400, 500, 600, even during the times of Muhammad. The Comforter was promised to believers before Muhammad came, but it was specifically promised first and foremost to the disciples who Jesus was speaking to. So Jesus promised the Comforter to the disciples. This means Muhammad could not be the Comforter, because Muhammad did not exist during the lifetime of the disciples. Jesus told us the Comforter was the Holy Spirit. This means Muhammad could not be the Comforter, because Jesus already told us who the Comforter was, the Holy Spirit. Now, if you call yourself Muslim and you don't have any idea who or what the Holy Spirit is, this verse will confuse you.
What it means, I don't know.
But to believers who believe in the three-person God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, we have no confusion. We have no lack of understanding. We know who the Holy Spirit is. Jesus said the disciples already knew the Comforter. This means Muhammad could not be the Comforter, because the disciples did not already know Muhammad. Jesus said the Comforter would be in the disciples. This means Muhammad could not be the Comforter, because Muhammad could not ever be in the disciples. Not even Muhammad's words could be in the disciples, because they did not exist until Muhammad began to utter his message. It is very clear, if you actually read what Jesus said, Muhammad cannot be the Comforter. The identity of the Comforter is well known. It is the Holy Spirit. If you are a Christian, do not allow yourself to be deceived. Muhammad cannot be the Comforter. If you call yourself Muslim, read what Jesus actually said, recorded in the Bible, and think about what Jesus actually said. Muhammad is not and cannot be the Comforter. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.